Did you know that while Christmas is often associated with joy and happiness, at least I like to associate it with joy and happiness, there's also a lot of people right now who are going through a time of suffering, a time of sadness, time of depression and loneliness. You might be wondering, like, why is that? What could be causing that, again, during a really happy time of the year? Well, the thing that could happen is that there could be a few things. One is that they could be separated from their family right now. For some reason, they may not be in the same place as their family, and they're separated, and they're experiencing this time alone. Another reason is they could be going through a divorce or a separation, and they're not with their family because of problems in their marriage. Another reason could be someone had lost a loved one over the course of the year, and this time of year doesn't bring happiness. It brings sadness so that they're experiencing this time without that person. And so today we're going to talk about what is it that you can do. Actually, we're going to talk about three specific things that you can do throughout this holiday season that can encourage someone and invite them in to experience joy and happiness, to get rid of the depression, the sadness, and experience joy and happiness. By the way, I'm Tom Pounder. I'm the online guy here at New Life Christian Church. And I'm really excited that you're here with me today. In fact, I would love for you to do this right now. Just share with me one thing you enjoy about Christmas time. What's the one thing that you enjoy? Put it in the comment section. I would love to catch up with you and hear what you enjoy about Christmas. Okay, so what are those three things? What are the things that you can do? The first thing that you can do is to invite someone in. Okay, invite someone in to what you or your family is currently doing. This isn't something like where you're creating something extra for your family to do. This is something where you're inviting someone in to be a part of what you and your family is experiencing. It could be like Christmas shopping. It could be just a family dinner. It could be a movie night. It could be a game night. It could be just something that your family is doing or something that you are doing. It could be, hey, I'm going to the gym. You want to come along with me? It's inviting them into your life and them to experience some community and get away from the isolation that they may be feeling, but experience some community and some friendship. 1 Peter 4:8-9 says this: above all, maintain constant love for one another, since love covers a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without complaining. Be hospitable without complaining. And the story I love to share about this is something I've shared in a previous devotional before, but a Thanksgiving story. When I was younger, my family and I, we went to church, we went to church this Thanksgiving day. And when we were walking out, my mom noticed that there was this homeless man right outside the church. And so she started interacting with this guy, and my brothers and I, again, we were much younger, we were wondering, like, what the heck is my mom doing? Why is she talking to this guy? And what she ended up doing was she ended up inviting this guy to our house for Thanksgiving dinner. And we're like, what the heck? This is our Thanksgiving. We were really upset, and we let our mom know about it, but my mom didn't care. She still invited this guy in, and my dad welcomed him with open arms as well. And what my family did was we had family dinner, we watched some football, and then afterwards, my parents made a plate for him and took him to a local hotel and paid for his night stay at the hotel. My mom and my dad were hospitable. They were showing compassion to this person. This person was lonely right now. I mean, he was homeless. My parents gave him some interaction, some encouragement during that time, and showed him God's love. And so what I want to encourage you to do is just simply invite someone in to what your family is doing or what you are doing. Now, the second thing you can do is very similar, but invite them to serve. You know, serving gives you purpose. Serving gives you fulfillment. Serving meets your needs in a really unique way. And I like to share the story about how I went on this mission trip between my junior and senior year in high school. And I had a good life. Things were going good for me, but I don't feel like I really had a sense of purpose or what I wanted to do in life. And then I went on this trip and I discovered two things. One is that serving God gave me fulfillment in life. And two is I love serving God with other people. Serving God and serving other people gave me true fulfillment in life. It gave me a sense of peace and satisfaction. Now, I still didn't know that I was going to be a youth minister down the road or work in online ministry. I didn't have that planned out for me, but it gave me purpose. It gave me fulfillment. And it made me think, I want to do this some more. And so if someone's going through loneliness or a time of despair or separation right now, invite them in to serve. That can help them. In fact, I love this passage from Proverbs 11:25. It says this, "The one who blesses others is abundantly blessed. Those who help others are helped." When you bless others, you're blessed. When you help others, you're helped. That's what serving does. That's what it does. And we've got lots of opportunities to serve during this holiday season here at New Life. All you have to do is go to newlife.church/serve to find out those information. All right, so the third thing that you can do is to encourage someone to start new traditions while also honoring other people. Now, again, if someone's going through a separation, someone going through a divorce, someone reflecting on a lost one that they had, what can you do to honor somebody or also start a new tradition? You know, I like to share the story about my mom. My mom, when we were living in Germany, she collected these wooden ornaments that she got from some of the Christmas shops over in Germany. And they were beautiful. They're great ornaments. And she got four of the same kind, one for each of my brothers and I. And then she stored them away. And then when we started our own families, she gave us those ornaments as a starting point for our families. And so what I did when I went through my separation and divorce, I needed a new Christmas tree because I didn't have one. So I had to go buy a Christmas tree with the girls. And so my girls and I, we bought a new one. And then what I decided to do, while honoring my mom, who was going through cancer at that time, and we ultimately lost her to cancer, while honoring my mom, but also starting a new tradition for my girls, is that I said, girls, every year we're going to go out and get one new ornament and we're going to store them. We're going to put them on our tree. But then every year when we pack them up, they go in your bag and then we'll keep on adding to them every single year. And so every year we add to those ornaments. And then the hope is that when they start their family, they will take those ornaments. Some of them are quite crazy, but still they're going to take those ornaments. And then they're going to use them on their Christmas tree with their family as they start new traditions of their own. So it was a fun new tradition for me and my girls while also honoring my mom. And so I would encourage you to, as you sit and talk with someone who's going through a tough time, is to think about what are some new traditions that you can start while also honoring the people that you lost. I love in the Old Testament, the Jewish people, whenever God did a great thing, they would honor what God had done by building up a monument so that they could take that monument whenever they passed it. They could say, this is what God did in this situation. This is what God did. And they can tell the story from time to time. You're creating new traditions here where your kids or your family members can start new traditions and tell the story of honoring people that you may have lost or gone through a tough time with. And so that's a great opportunity for you to do that. All right, so those are the three things I thought of. I'm sure there's other things, and if you have other ideas, definitely put it in the comment section. I would love to talk to you about that or read what you're hearing about, and I would love to talk to you more. And if you're going through a hard time and you need someone to talk to, you can talk to me. You can email me at tomp@newlife.church. I would love to talk to you a little bit more about this and see what this looks like for you as you go into this new stage in your life and you're going through the holiday seasons right now. Hey, let me pray, and then we'll wrap up. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for today, and thank you for who you are. Thank you for guiding us and directing us. And while this may be a challenging season for us today, I pray, Lord, that you would lead us so that we can have peace, fulfillment, and joy this holiday season as we celebrate the birth of you so many years ago. So, Lord, we thank you and praise your name. Amen. And I am serious. I would love to talk to you a little bit more. So if you have questions or thoughts, feel free again to email me, tomp@newlife.church. I hope and pray that you have a blessed day today.